Hey guys, welcome to the Massive Iron Channel. I'm Steve Shaw. In this video, I'm going to give you a simple deadlift tip that will help you nail form, and it deals with how your shoulder position is relative to the barbell. Before I get into this topic, if you have any questions or comments, drop them down below. The best topic ideas I turn into videos just like this. Don't forget to check out the link down below. I have a new app out, and now until next Monday, you can sign up for only $1. And get entered to win a power bar and plates or a $300 PayPal gift card. Power bar and plates are from Bells of Steel. All right, so I got some slides here. And this is something you rarely see talked about when it comes to deadlift form. I'm going to show you guys how to take a video from the side on your deadlift. And to help you analyze, are your shoulders too far forward, shoulders too far back, shoulders right where they need to be? Now, a lot of times when you're looking at deadlift form, we'll look at hips, okay? Well, folks will look at hips. Your hips are too high, your hips are too low. But along with this, you also want to look at your shoulder position relative to the bar. Now, here, in this first picture, you can see the mid shoulder is a little bit forward of the barbell. That's pretty much exactly where you want it to be. You don't want your shoulder right over the barbell because when that happens, your hips are too low. And when your hips are too low and you pull, they're going to come up because they're going to seek a better leverage position. And that's going to throw off your deadlift. Now, if your shoulders are too far forward, more forward than this in front of the bar, your hips are going to be too high. And the same thing is going to happen when you go to pull. Your hips are going to fly up because you're out of your leverage comfort zone. So basically, the long and short of it is shoulders too far back, your hips are down, and they're going to come up when you pull. Shoulders too far forward, and your hips are high, and they're going to remain they're going to stay high or go even higher when you pull. So this is a position you want. Generally, shoulders just a little bit in front of the barbell or basically your scapula area right in front of the barbell. All right, and next picture here, someone pulling. These are examples of basically what you don't want to do. Here, the top one in the red with the red line, shoulders right over the barbell. You want to have your shoulders, a little bit more forward than that. The bottom picture, the shoulders are too far forward. You can see the hips are up. In both cases, you're likely to see your hips coming up when you pull. So it's kind of in between these. All right, next slide. Again, examples of the left example is a shoulder too far forward over the barbell. You can see hips are up when you pull. You're going to be in a bad leverage position. This is going to kill your lower back. The right picture is a little bit better. It's almost shoulders over the barbell. This is a case where for some lifters, shoulders over the barbell are or moving towards shoulders over the barbell might make more sense because of the guy's leverages. But you can still see your average, your shoulders just a little bit in front of the barbell. That's something you want to watch for. Do my hips look in a good leverage position? On the picture on the left, are my shoulders way too far in front of the barbell? Now, this one I ripped from Strong Lifts. I found these pictures on the internet. I want to give credit where credit is due. The top picture, you can see that your shoulders are over the barbell. Hips are too low. You don't have quality leverage here. When you pull, your hips are going to fly up and it's going to put extra pressure on your lower back. The second picture, obviously, shoulders are too far in front of the barbell and that's going to raise your hips. And the bottom picture is darn near perfect with your shoulders just about in front, a little bit in front of the barbell. Your hips are in a good leverage position, etc. Now, you might have to dial in your shoulders a little bit. The key here is you want to have your shoulders a little bit in front of the barbell while your hips feel in a strong, natural leverage position. And again, just one more, a couple more photos here. The photo on the right shows the shoulders are way too far forward, way too far forward. And when he pulls, those hips are going to just want to come up as well. And one last picture. This is from powerliftingtechnique.com. He describes it as having your shoulder blades over the barbell. You can see here, the shoulder is just in front of the bar. The shoulder blades are over the barbell. Hips are in a good leverage position. And when this individual pulls, he's going to be in the best position to have a solid pull, the least amount of stress on his lower back. Now, from this position, you don't want to try to yank the barbell up. What you want to try to do is follow this white line and try to drive your shoulders straight up to move the weight. So guys, hope this video has been of some help. If you have any questions or comments, drop them down below. If you made it this far in this video and have yet to subscribe to my channel, please do. I'd appreciate the support. So guys, as always, thanks for watching. Have a great day.